Hey there, Geoff Manchester here from iZotope. Ozone 11 was a massive release for us this year, and today we've decided to let you folks add the powerful and flexible EQ from Ozone to your toolkit completely for free. And speaking of free plugins, you can also grab Komplete Start, a free production bundle by Native Instruments that includes synths, Kontakt instruments, effects, and hundreds of sounds. To get both Ozone EQ and Komplete Start for free, head to the links in the description below. Ozone is, of course, our mastering suite of tools, but many people use its modules outside of common mastering workflows. So in this video, I'm going to quickly walk you through all of the functionality that's built into this very powerful plugin across a number of individual tracks. Now, to learn more about what Ozone can do to your mastered tracks, check the pop-out link above and head to the description for even more videos and resources. So when you open up the component Ozone 11 EQ, it's going to look something like this. And just so you know, if you want to make it bigger, you can by going over here and dragging this out to make it more or less full screen. Or you can bring it back to a smaller default size, throw it on another monitor. It's completely up to you. Now, you'll notice that we're already parked here on some work that I was doing, which involves processing transient and or sustained information in the signal. This is a brand new feature in Ozone 11, in the EQ and other modules as well. And to get where I got, all you have to do is go to the drop-down menu in the center. It'll look something like this when you open the plugin up for the first time, and click to find transient sustain. And it's worth mentioning, you can also affect the mid or the side, left and right, and transient sustain, or just work in stereo if that's what you want to do. So I'm going to go back here to transient and sustain. And what I can do is first hear the portions of the transient or sustained elements of this guitar track, and then get to work enhancing or curtailing aspects of those two said portions of the signal. So first of all, we could just listen to the transient information in this guitar track by going to the solo button here and listening. I can do the same thing for sustain. And here's everything all together. So let's say that what I wanted to do was bring out some of the warmth of this guitar by amplifying some of the sustain information. To do that, I'm going to make sure that I do what I just did, which is click to make sure that this gray circle is around the sustain word, as opposed to it being around the transient word. If we're in the transient mode of processing, this will have a gray outline behind it, and the sustain will be not affected. So let's make sure we click that. Now we are working with the sustained elements of this track. So now what I'll do is just do a little bit of EQ work and maybe draw out some of the low end information where I think some of the sustain is happening, predominantly in this acoustic guitar track. But if I'm not sure, you can always option and click to solo around the signal and make sure that your processing will be super localized to the things that you want. So in this case, like I said, my hunch is there's some sustained information happening here in the lows and low mids. I'm going to use the option click to really investigate to make sure that I can target my processing appropriately. So I pretty much confirmed what I was hearing. So now with sustain engaged, I will make a little boost here. One more thing that I can do is make sure that I'm really processing the low end and drawing out the sustain information in this guitar track by hitting the delta button. What delta is going to do is essentially perform a null test so that I can hear the focus of the processing in the EQ. So when I press this, I'm going to hear just the difference between the before and after, so where my processing is being localized to. So that lets me know that I'm really drawing out the low-end sustained information. Let's do a before and after with the bypass button. Now, obviously, that sounds like what I want it to. We've drawn out the sustained portion in the low end, but it also sounds a bit louder. And how can I be sure if my moves sound better if they just sound louder? Because we're often fooled into thinking that louder sounds better. So to take loudness out of the equation, I can press the gain match feature, and now it'll match the before and after loudness-wise so that all we hear is the result of our sustain processing. So if when I'm in gain match mode, I find that I actually need a bit more juice, I don't have to go back to this node here to boost things up. I can actually use the amount over here option to scale things a little bit more extreme or a little bit more conservative or all the way down here to zero. So we can experiment with that with gain match on, of course. I'm definitely getting that woodiness from the guitar, which works for me because I think this track might work really well in a ballad, and I want that guitar to be spotlit. So I don't want to shave too much low end off of it. I want it to be, you know, front and center. And I've drawn out a lot of the warm tones that are sustained using the new transient sustain processing here. Let's go to another example, and let's draw out the transient elements of a drum track. I don't really have to commit to anything right away. I can just pull up a node by clicking on the plus button to bring one out over here, or I could bring out a bell shape over here. It's contextual, by the way. So if we click in the lower region, we're going to bring up a low shelf. In the higher region, we're going to bring up a high shelf. And somewhere in the middle, we have some bells over here. So what I'll do is double click to return these to their default position and just scrub around with transient grade over here and listen to what I like. So let's do a game match before and after. And one thing you can play around with is the analog versus digital modes. We have two modes here, and analog is basically your minimum phase EQ, whereas digital gives you the ability to select degrees of linear phase EQ. So over here I'm in digital and I can click on the node and open the mini heads-up display and click this partition. And now I can manipulate the degree of phase shift over here. So that's pretty handy. We don't get that with the analog mode over here. See, it's grayed out. And if you want to be extra nerdy about it, you can click on the gear wheel and you can go to the EQ and show extra curves. And now we can see our phase response, phase delay, and group delay for both digital and analog. So that's pretty nerdy, pretty techie. So I've enhanced the transient information. Let's bring out a little bit of low end, sustained low end, I should say, over here with a sustained low shelf. Again, we can scale this either forward or back in terms of intensity with this amount slider here. And after bringing up the sustained elements of the low end and the transient elements of the high end, let's do a gain match before and after. Let's take a detour and go through a more traditional workflow with an EQ. And in this case, I have an acoustic guitar track and a vocal that are playing together in a country style ballad. Some days are tough. You're the only one to know when you've had enough. You've got your reasons for giving up. So something I'd like to do is bring a little bit of control to this guitar and have it not be so boomy and woody. And for those of you that don't really know where to start when you're EQing, it's always a good idea to go to the presets. And even though Ozone's EQ is a mastering tool, there's tons of presets that are designed for any kind of application. So what I'm gonna do is just scroll through and take a listen and see if there's something that's kind of working for me, which I will then tweak. You're the only one to know when you've had enough. You've got your reasons for giving up. It's the same old situation with your dumb, dumb love. You spend all your time hanging on to a yesterday that's dead and gone. I should like gentle polish because it's rolling off some of these lows, which is part of my mission here. Some days are tough. You're the only one to know when you've had enough. You've got your reason. We can see a lot of energy moving here, so what I'm gonna do is use this bell that was at first up here and use it to suppress some of that energy that I can see in the spectra. Some days are tough. You're the only one to know when you've had. I wanna further enhance this, and what I'll do by enhancing the high end here is just add a Baxandall treble shelf here. Some days are tough. You're the only one to know when you've had enough. You've got your reason. So this is going to bring out some of the sparkle and finger noise at the top of the guitar. We've rolled off some of the lows. I can change the slope here. Something a bit more gentle. Some days are tough. You're the only one to know when you've had enough. You've got your reasons for giving up. It's the same old situation with your dumb, dumb love. You spend all your time hanging on. Let's see how that sounds with a before and after. Some days are tough. You're the only one to know when you've had enough. You've got your reasons for giving up. It's the same old situation with your dumb, dumb love. You spend all your time hanging on. Yesterday that's dead and gone. It's high time you get to moving on. Believe it or not, you're right where you belong. So I find that with these moves, the vocal has room to be heard and articulate. And the guitar isn't too thumpy and woody because we've done some high passing over here in the lows. I could further tweak this, but hopefully this gives you a sense of just how easy it is to work with Ozone 11's EQ, starting with a preset and tweaking it from there until you find something that really suits whatever the material is that you're working on. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Be sure to leave us a comment below on how you plan to use the Ozone 11 EQ in your next production. And with that, I'll I'll see you in the next one. Bye.